Yes, we're about to start. The two masters are coordinating things. Good Shabbos, everyone.
Teach us, repeat after me, teach us, to treasure each day. It's as simple as that. That we may open our hearts to your wisdom.
That we may open our hearts to your wisdom.
And then come back, teach us,
to
treasure each day.
That we may open our hearts
together. Barbara's here. Who knows what the Torah portion is this week? It's a double portion. Bahar, Bahar, and Bechukosai. In my mind, it's closer. What does Bahar mean? What does Bahar? Anyone? Bahar.
Bahar means to go down. Bahar in Spanish.
Bahar in Spanish. That's good. So, Har is mountain. And Bihar is in the mountain. Not on the mountain, Al-Hahar, but Bihar, in the mountain. Why does it say in the mountain instead of on the mountain?
Is that
the
laughter?
What was that? Canned laughter. That was canned laughter. So, Jorge, just when I'm speaking, just turn it down a little, just the thing, just when I'm speaking, the feedback. Thank you, brother. So.
It's the core.
Yeah? Say it again.
It's the call. It's the call.
Good, good. Yeah. It's the call. It's inside, beautiful. I love it. Give me more. Give me more hippie Torah. give it to me. Mountain instead of all the mountain. Yes.
Okay.
I love it. So the mountain, right, is indicative of the mind. Because we are a cerebral gentry as Jews. So everything is intellect for us. It's a little too much sometimes. And so when it says Bihar, it means within the mind, but not just within the mind, that God meets you. Not at the top of the mountain, but right where you are in your mind. Wherever you are, in the words of Baal Shem Tov, the great father of Jewish mysticism, where your thoughts are, there you are entirely. It flies in the face of Descartes, you know? Where you are, your thoughts are, and where your thoughts are, entirely. So where God meets you is wherever you are. If you have meaning here at the plateau here, that's where God says, let's have meaning here. Let's have ritual here. Let's have understanding here. And when you're on the 10th level or the penthouse, wherever you are, God says, I'm there with you. I'm there with you wherever you are. Now, can we do that with each other? Because that kind of mobility is enlightenment. We don't climb to the top of a mountain and look down at everyone else and say, ha, 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 and plant my flag, right? We climb because it's the exercise of climbing. And then we go down because we go down. We descend. That's human nature. And if our friends are descending, then we help them up, wherever they're at. Mostly it teaches us that you can find meaning anywhere.
Yes.
wherever you are, be there. It's like God's space. It's like honoring what's around us, not just zoom, zoom, zoom. Just take it in.
I know.
Let it be, you know, try.
I know all the people that are were coming tonight are late, right? So wherever they are, God is there too. Doug, our flautist, practices that all the time. And so the idea is that tonight let's explore meaning wherever it is. Wherever it is. Heiliger Robinson, give me a little something.
Thank you.
God moves, meets you where you are. So, Bob, give me the drumming one.